Okay, part three. So I knocked my graphics down a little bit. Looks like there's still a little tiny bit of screen tear, but we'll see what we can do here. Okay, so it's been about a week since I did part two, so I told myself I need to get in here and get. Oh, that's neat. Need to get part three going before I forget and I get too much War Thundering in. All right, so. Oh. Hello. Okay, let's bring up our journal and we'll set the illustrated manual for Vicar Max to go find that journal there and we'll go do that next. Okay, that's off that way. All right. Hello, gang.
For me.
Ouch. Ow, ow, ow. One down. Okay. Probably should hit the old inhaler, I think. Oops. Ah, I forgot about that. All right, let's a little bit of health back. Very nice. Take all the goodies we can get from these guys. An assault rifle, very nice. And there. The other one up here has got nothing. Okay. Okay. So, let's presumably, if this is an outpost outside of town, it's probably going to also be. Yep, there they are. I see them. Okay, let's change my inventory over to the assault rifle here. There we go. There we go. There we go. And 54 damage, 73 damage. We'll take the saber for phase four. Okay. There we go. Don't have a lot of ammo for this, so we'll have to make those count. Probably what I should. Oh, here's somebody. Oh, he's no longer with us. Ah, okay. How many of them are there? Ah. Take that, thank you. Well, they got a dog. Okay. That worked rather well. All right. I'll take that. Leveled up again. Oh, I'll take everything you've got. A ringleader. Nice. Pristine items have a diamond in their condition meter. Very nice. I'm guessing I might have just picked up a pristine item. Okay. Make sure we checked everybody here. Looks like it. So the marauders must be killing each other too, would seem. All right. Okay, where's Parvati? Is she okay? Oh yeah, she seems to be all right. Okay, I need to give her some weapons for her inventory too, I guess. All right, let's see what's in here. Go with the shotgun in here. Check out the skill points soon. What's this? Oh, yes, thank you. Oh, I guess I can't open that one. Okay, I don't have the... I don't have those little things to open that with. Okay, when the collector's thing is... this. Can't tell what that is. Okay. Like we're next door to the collector's spot? No, apparently we are at the collector's spot, so where is the book? Ah. Use terminal. Let's see what the messages are. Oh, interesting. Clement! I must disagree with you. I find I must disagree with your theories about the Earth Directorate's place in the colonial system. Sadly, as much as I appreciate the board and the new frontier they've opened for us, I believe Halcyon and all the other colonies on the rim of the galaxy would fall to pieces or war amongst themselves if the Earth Directorate wasn't around to regulate trade and settle disputes. Do you think the corporations would accept the mandated inclusion of an Earth Minister if they had a choice in the matter? Jefferson. Jefferson, of course, I'd never dispute that Earth is the heart of the whole colonial system, but the real adventure and independent spirit upon which humankind truly thrives is to be found out here among the furthest colonies. I still think you're wrong about the history, though. The discovery of the skip drive was not what gave the Earth Directorate power over the corporations. The high costs of the Great War left them in a weakened state, and the skip drive was simply the extra leverage the Directorate needed to return to power. Clement. Okay. Guess that is it. Interesting. Alright, well, where is the, where's the book? How do I know which house is the collector's house, though? Alright, let's hit the skill points while we're here and they're staring at me. 10 points available, alright. We wanna upgrade here. But oh, there we go. Okay. I'm looking at like trying to do each individual one of these, but it's the overall thing. I got it. Okay, cool. We'll put 3 into there. Put a couple more into here. 5 more available. Dialogue is good. I definitely needed more dialogue. And we'll go with ranged and defense. Okay. We'll apply that. Yes, that's fine. Skills. Do I have a perk yet, or do we have a perk? No, we don't have any perks. Oh, it's every 2 levels for perks? Every 2 levels, I think. Okay. Journal. Book collector. Okay, so obviously the book collector is probably going to have a bunch of books in the house, so we're probably not in the right house. Okay, that's fine. Ah. I'm guessing we could have snuck around. Gone up that way. Neat. All right, let's see if we can find a book collector. A refrigerator. Nothing in it, though. Eh. Doesn't seem to be much here. Oh, what's that? Vicer's Corona. Okay. Oh, that's cannery. Okay, now I see it says cannery on it. Evicted. Nice. Wonder if we can get inside. Can we get inside from the back? Guessing probably not. Doesn't look like it. Alright, let's see if it's in this house here. Whoa. Yes, thank you. Okay, so it must be It must be this house somehow. What am I missing here? This cannery, though. Can we get in this other house over here somehow? No? It says it's the collector's domicile, so what is it? Where's this book we're supposed to find? Unless this is it? Is it in here? Hmm. See if Parvati knows anything.
Something you need? You mean why I'm not allowed in the store anymore? There was a kind of a thing with a vending machine when I was 12. Not intentionally. I've always been good with my hands, right? So I saw a lock on the machine and thought, oh, this must be how they refill it. But I had to know. So I did my thing. And next thing I know, there's a couple hundred bottles of Zero G rolling out the front door and into the road.
I can see how that could upset some people. Go with you pick the lock on the vending machine.
Well, sure. They're not tough. Even back then, before I got real good at that sort of thing. Right about then, a bunch of loaders came rolling in the gate, fresh off the salt tuna ships. And Mr. Thompson was up on the porch, making a speech about how everyone would have to volunteer a third shift to get it all canned. Anyhow, you ever seen an auto loader run over a bottle of Zero G?
Oh my god. Go on.
Exploded all over Mr. Thompson. One bottle after another as the loaders went by. I was just shy of working age, so Dad had to pay all the damages. Moreau's still angry at me.
Oh dear.
I can laugh about it now, but I just about puked up my guts in terror in the moment. That's the one time I ever made Mr. Thompson look a fool.
Alright, well, I wonder if I can get her to pick this lock over here.
Got it. Inside voices.
Is there a way that I can get you to pick this? Let's see. Okay, okay. Let's check and see what I wanted. Inventory. How do I give something to Parvati, though? Aha. All right, she can have that. Okay. So this is supposed to be the collector's domicile, but can't find the book. Another lock. We got two locks. We need to get those things. I'm an idiot. I just got the letter today. Corporate ordered me to relocate the Edgewater Cannery, effective immediately. It's a shame. I was really looking forward to running my own gift shop at the community center, selling rare memorabilia. But scripture tells us that all things happen for a reason. Work fortifies the spirit and all. As for my book collection, I can't bear to part with it. Don't want those books moldering in some contraband locker. So I stashed them all away in a cave over by the river. Aha! Okay. So we've searched, and we gotta find the cave over by the river. Man, down by the... Oh my goodness! Hey, alright. Hey! Magpick. I just need one more of those. Okay. I like the washing area over here. Where's this cooking? I guess that's cooking. Okay, Parvati, I think we got everything we can get out of here. Oh. Okay, you can sleep. Oh. Oh, resting in bed. Okay, cool. Alright. Parvati, let's move along to the, presumably that's the cave over by the river now. That would be a river, looks like. Okay. Alright, that's where we're heading. I think we can afford to run. Go find the vicar's book for him. So we got... We're looking for a cave by the river that's over that way.
Got it. Heads down.
Whoops. Okay, we got... Couple marauders there. Sing. We got. Oh, what? It. Oh my God. Oh, there's. Oh, lovely. That's great. I think we're gonna go sneaking. We're not going to try to engage over there if we can help it. Oh my goodness. Over here. This is kind of where I wish I had some grenades. I don't think we're gonna make it through here without getting involved in some kind of fight, though. Okay, well, we're gonna have to get past these guys at least to get to where the cave is. Dog down there. I sure hope this doesn't draw those guys over. I don't want to have to fight them. But we'll go with them for now.
Don't mess with us.
Okay, good. Doesn't look like we drew the attention of the, primal things up there, so that's good. Took these guys out fairly quickly. Let's see what they got. Anything good? Mammo. Good, good, good. Cave entrance. Oh, goody. And I think we'll save real quick. Okay. The illustrated manual. Check what the journal has to say. Okay. Nothing new. Okay. So far, so good. Yep. Realized a little too late what that probably was, which should have been fairly obvious, I think. Oh well. Heavy ammo, energy cell. This one's empty. Okay. What we got here? Hey, mag pick. Mag pick. Car mac and cheese. Oh, I can actually pick this one. Ah, okay. So that was illegal, but there shouldn't have been anybody to see me, so it shouldn't have been. Right, we'll take that. Got the manual of M. Baikonur Cosmodrome. Let's see if there's a way I can disable this thing. Nope. Okay, I bet there's a way to do it eventually, but I probably don't have the skill to do it yet. Zero G brew. Very nice. Okay, my health seems to be recovering itself slowly on its own. I think we're good. Let's see what else is in the back of the cave here. Oh, it's an exit on the other side. Presumably near those primal dudes, which I probably don't want to do. Yep. Oh dear. Yeah, back this way, Parvati. You know what? We're going to not go that way. We'll go back the way we came, and we'll take the circle route back. Unless something really exciting happens, I'm going to skip forward to us getting back to town, because it should just be travel time, so. Unless something happens where we get engaged or whatever, we'll see you back at town. Mantisaur, well, doesn't that seem like it's fun? Okay. There is. The cannery, so the vicar should be down here.
Been eating nothing but salt tuna for a year.
There we are. Nothing particularly exciting happened. We've got the book for the vicar. Let's deliver it to him and see what happens. We'll save real quick just in case.
Any progress on that matter we discussed?
Why, yes, in fact. I've got your book right here.
Wonderful. This is fantastic. Well worth all the sacrifices I... Wait. What the fuck is this?
Oh my god.
Is this French? I can't fucking read French. It's a law-forsaken joke is what it is. French. Ha! I was so high and mighty, preaching to the yokels about following the plan, while fighting it at every turn.
That's funny. I'm gonna go with number three here.
There is little more important than such a precious, rare text. I've spent my life searching for the keys to unlocking the secrets of the universal equation that underlies the plan. I had hoped this book held some of those answers. I became so desperate, I even got myself assigned to this plague-ridden backwater to find the damn thing. All the time and suffering I've spent. Wasted.
Huh. Let's see. One or two. Which one? One or two. I'll go with two.
Baikonur, the author, had some interesting theories about man's perception of reality that I thought could be applied to our attempts to decipher the plan. Unfortunately, he was also one of the founders of the Philosophist school of thought, so the book is banned in this colony.
I see. Let's go with one.
Philosophism's a false religion that stands in contradiction to almost everything we know to be true. They believe all is chaos, in stark contrast to OSI's belief in the plan. but most of the philosophist perversion of Bokonu's thoughts came more than a century after his death.
Okay. Let's go with two.
Please. As if my life should have no greater meaning than proselytizing to a bunch of feeble-minded wretches. Nothing could be more excruciating than discussing the true nature of reality with people who have no interest beyond their next Aetherwave program. But that's neither here nor there. What I need to do now is to find a translator, obviously. But to do that, I'll first need to secure transport.
And I think we got ourselves a companion.
Perhaps I could make myself of use to your crew.
Why, yes. Shepherd looking for a book?
Certainly. I already gave you most of my money, but I can offer you free spiritual counseling, and I'd be happy to watch your back. I'm pretty handy with a tossball stick, or any blunt instrument, really. I'm also a passable gunhand.
A tossball stick, you say?
To that. I can usually talk my way out of conflict, though.
Okay.
Oh, I'm fairly competent at hacking computers.
Well! That all part of your vicar training?
Well, understanding computers is, though I admit I took it further than most. And I was quite the 32nd back during my seminary days. Left many an opponent bleeding on the field.
All right. I'm going to go with, are you even a vicar?
Of course. I'm a vicar who is dedicated to his calling. More dedicated than any other you'll find in this colony. I joined the OSI to help decipher the grand plan. But instead, I ended up the vicar in a prison due to ignorance and politics. Then I came here. Satisfied?
Sounds good. Let's go. Okay, well, I'm going to ask him about prison duty, I guess.
Most lay people are not aware of this, but we've not discovered any new insights into the plan for a long, long time. I had an idea that we should welcome the truth, no matter where we found it. I had the worse idea to share my thoughts with a superior.
Yeah, that's the way things tend to go.
And that's the long and short of it. So, what do you think?
Sounds good, let's go.
Fantastic. Let me get my things in order and I'll catch up with you.
Edgewater's gonna miss you. Folk here always had good things to say about their vicar.
Thank you, Ms. Holcomb. I'll be glad for the change of scenery, and to leave this place behind. I shall see you on the ship, Captain, whenever you're ready to leave Emerald Vale.
All right. Hey. If enemies are hostile, but your reputation isn't kill on sight, leaving for a few days will calm things down. Okay. Well, I think that's a good place to leave off for part three. We've gained another companion. We've leveled up. So we'll add those crew points in at the beginning of the next video. Crew points. Skill points. We'll add those skill points in at the beginning of the next video, and we'll continue on with our next quest here. Okay. Which would be getting the power and heading out to talk to these people. Okay. Cool. Well, we'll see you in part four then.